Oh. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O God, Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who lived and reigned.
At that time, Jesus said to the crowd, "The kingdom of heaven is like a net which was thrown into the sea and gathered fish of every kind. When it was full, men drew it ashore. It sat down and sorted the good into vessels, but threw the grain on bad. So it will be at the close of the age. The angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into the furnace of fire. There men will weep and gnash their teeth." Have you understood all this? They said to him, "Yes." And he said to them, "Therefore every scribe who has been trained for the kingdom of heaven is like a householder who brings out of his treasure what is new and what is old." The Gospel of the Lord.
When Mr. Griffin asked me to be the homilist at this mass, my first inclination was to respond that This newness of life we seek is not just for our We actually have a little text for it, taken from the Coverdale Psalter, verse 9, Psalm 96. O worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness, let the whole earth stand in awe of Him. The beauty of holiness, a phrase which was not unfamiliar to our beloved St. Martin Newman, having been a priest for about 12 years before he became Catholic. Newman equates the beauty of holiness to, quote, a tender and eager affection towards our Lord and Savior, close quote. He also refers to it as the ultimate end of man, the pattern of Christ. Now, I'm not a Newman scholar and expert like some of you probably are, but I'm working on it. I really only got to know him in the last 12 years or so, thanks to Father Catania's influence, as all of us at the Father Church of Baltimore became Catholic together into the Ordinariate. I hadn't even finished reading the definitive biography of Newman by Father Armando Alejandro, may he rest in peace. But despite my lack of expertise regarding Newman, I can safely say that his life, his whole life, was aimed at coming to know truth, the fullness of truth, with greater certitude in infinite fear or kind of light. As a saint, Newman has found that fullness and perfect light of truth in the beauty of vision. That's what the beauty of holiness is, the fullness of truth. In the beauty of holiness, we find the fullness of truth. In the beauty of truth, we find holiness. Since beauty originates in God and proceeds from Him, all that participates in beauty draws it from God while manifesting it in various ways. There is the beauty of nature, which is drawn toward heavenly beauty as its final end. But the clearest sign of beauty in this life is holiness. Newman said, a really holy man, a true saint, has a sort of secret power in him to attract others to him who are like-minded, and to influence all or anything in them like him. Elsewhere, he calls it a catching force. Newman recognized the power of beauty in nature, in music, architecture, poetry, a well-written letter, in prayer, meditation, and in worship, but most of all, in truth itself. That's why his whole life was a journey out of shadows and into truth, because he was on a journey toward holiness. Truth and holiness are not easily found, especially these days, but as they remain here, we must search for them diligently. But they can be found, and Newman reminds us how. It is only as we labor to change our nature through God's help and to serve Him truly that we begin to discern the beauty of holiness. Have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For Thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please Thee in newness of life. May St. John and Newman intercede for God's continued blessings upon all of you here, especially on this association there in His name, as well as the Durandus Institute and St. Luke's Parish of the Ordinariate of the Church of St. John and Newman.
That your church members never pick you out of your stance and are not carrying your fingers as intent to be unified, following the commandments of God and walking from His heart to His holy ways. God, hear our faith. Make your humble confession to Almighty God.
Almighty God.
long and truly turned to him. Come unto me, all ye that travail, and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Here also what St. Paul said, this is a true saying that what you want will be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Here also what St. John said, if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world.
The Lord be with you.
Thank you. brethren, that this my sacrifice and yours may be accepted. God, Father,
and the Lord accept the sacrifice of thy hands, the praise of your name, for our good and the good of all the Holy Church.
Thank you.
Except for the Christ, 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 except for the Christ Thank you. Thank you.
blessing of God Almighty.